Good evening, everybody, and welcome to Open Mic Night live at the ZoomBarDC. We've got an amazing show for you tonight. We've got Steve Woolwine, Joseph Stegner, Megan Ukoh, Bill Sherman, Jeremy Schuhmann, Scott Kaplowitz, Dave Sherman, Tom Mann, and more. So sit back, relax. We're going to have an amazing, and Emily Griswold, her first open mic ever. This is so exciting. So this is going to be awesome. So sit back, relax, and Dave Sherman's going to kick us off. Take it away, Dave.
Well, all right, this is an experiment that I've been working with and trying to find the right key, and I think I did. We'll see. This is an Aretha Franklin tune.
Great. He's great.
If you want my loving, if you really do, don't be afraid now, baby, just ask me. You know I'm gonna give it to you. I do declare I wanna see you within. Stretch out your arms, little girl, you're gonna get it. I love you. Ain't no doubt about it, baby, I love you. I love you, I love you, I love you, baby, I love you. If you feel you want to kiss me, go right ahead, I don't mind. All you got to do is snap your fingers, baby, and I'll come running, I ain't lying. I heard you once, little girl, you're gonna get it. I deny my own self before I see you without it, 'cause I love you. Ain't no doubt about it, baby, I love you. I love you, I love you, I love you, baby, I love you. I wanna run away and leave me sitting here crying. If it's all the same to you, baby, I'm gonna stop you from saying goodbye. Baby, I love you. Baby, I need you. Baby, I want you. I got to have you. Don't let your neighbors say that I don't want you. Baby, I love you. Baby, I want you. Baby, I need you. Baby, I love you.
Right on. Right on.
So that's the right key, I think. Thank you.
Which Aretha song is it?
Yeah, I mean, Aretha originally did it, yeah.
What's the name?
It didn't sound like that.
I did a little. What was the other key option?
You name it. I tried it.
I tried them all.
Aretha did it in G.
Wait, and so you did it higher than the original key, but probably not higher than Aretha.
Yes and no.
Right. You technically did it seven steps down.
It is, I mean, it's a whole step down, but at the same time, it's too low in some places and too high in other places. I tried E.
It sounded great.
But okay, well, that's where it's staying then.
Right on. Got me on the dance floor, so that's all that matters.
I noticed.
That's the intention. Well, this should get you on the dance floor too. It's another new tune that I'm working up for this new band that I'm in called, what's it called? Don't Look Up. What that means, I don't know. But anyway, it's a little thing called Love and War. Now in love and war, all is fair. That's what the people say. Now I know that this love of ours, each and every day, love and war, love and war, love and war, baby, what are we fighting for? Now we turn our home into a battleground, played me for a fool. Now I know in love and war there's no such thing as rules. Love and war, love and war, love and war, baby, what are we fighting for? Now I tried and tried to treat you right, we don't see eye to eye. One more fight like last night, baby, and it's got to be goodbye. Love and war, love and war, love and war, baby, what are we fighting for? Well, I've seen it happen time and time again. Not gonna happen to me. I can't let myself become another love casualty. Love and war, love and war, love and war, baby, what are we fighting for? Love and war, baby, what are we fighting for?
Cha, cha, cha.
Woo!
Thank you.
Another great dance song. Yay.
Yeah, there's a time Don't Look Up applies. I've told you that story about when I got shot on the bus. But when I was holding my wounds and waiting for the ambulance to get to arrive and trying to just calm my heart and keep it from pumping the blood out, I heard a voice, hey, can I use your phone? And I thought, man, if I just saw everything that happened here and I was stuck outside a bus in the middle of the night, I'd want to call somebody. So with kind of a joy in my heart, I said, sure, go ahead. Yeah. And I never looked up. Had I looked up, I would have seen a sawed-off shotgun pointing at me, and it may have changed the chemistry of the situation. But as it turned out, he just picked up the phone and walked off the bus, and I'm still alive, which is why, again, another plug for the Golden Rule, because I think that's one of the times the Golden Rule saved my life. I heard a request to use a phone, and with the sincerity of my heart, I granted it, and he chose not to pull the trigger, and I'm alive. So don't look up. It sometimes works.
You're right. Now I understand.
There you go.
Now I understand. I didn't come up with a name. The bass player, actually the bass player's wife named the band, and I said, sure, why not?
I came up with this song, and the more you look up, the more you say, wow, like a few days before I got shot. And I like that perspective. The more you look up, the more you say, wow. But anyway, thank you. That was
song beautiful. In there.
That was fun.
Wow. That's a tough act to follow, Joseph. Thank you. Dave. Thanks, Dave. Let's see. Steve, you want to go next?
Sure.
On the Don't Look Up and Back, the famous novel in the 30s was Look Back in Anger. And then Bob Dylan wrote a competing song later, Don't Look Back.
Well, there was a movie called Don't Look Back, which was about Bob Dylan.
I know, it was taken from the title of his song.
From the title of the song, right.
You got everything she needs, she's an artist, you don't look back. Anyway, it was like his response to Thomas Wolfe's novel.
You learn something new every day.
That's right. Okay, Steve, you are up.
All right, you hear me?
Yep.
We ride past the same buildings, a thousand times. Never ever knowing what's on the inside. Till we grow numb and accept the place we've arrived. Sometimes you gotta see a new place if you're ever gonna change your mind. We could stay in one place till it becomes a state of your mind. Follow your heart. It knows where to go. It's a simple thing to say, but harder to know. But three simple words let you know where you know. Looking over the valley, and it always feels like home. Sidewalks in the city to the buildings made of stone. But home is where your heart is, and it's a shame when it leaves you alone. So you better follow your heart in all that you do. Lead you where you're going, and always be true. No matter the cost, trust it in all that you do. Could be the best advice I can give to you. Follow your heart. It knows where to go. It's a simple thing to say, but harder to know. But three simple words let you know when you know. No one has all the answers, but it's in each of us, I'm told. Follow your heart, it knows where to go.
Dave, did you just write that one?
Yeah, I did. I wrote it this week.
Yeah, I picked that figure. I thought so, because I hadn't heard it before, but it was obviously you.
Steve, I really think if you just made an album of your ZoomBarDC recordings, you'd have a hit record. I mean, almost every time you play, you could make me cry. So you just really, and because it's the lyrics and the emotion and the sound, the voice, the guitar, all of it. And just what you play here alone would make a hit album. That's my opinion.
Yeah, you're very talented.
that means a lot coming from this group for sure. I thought about it. The idea of putting like maybe six songs together and kind of really doing them good, it's possible.
We could just get Joseph to edit them together. And then you'd have a demo and then you'd be almost done.
You know, I don't have equipment worthy of that. I wish I did. My son does though, so I can work on that. Yeah, okay.
Well, let me see if I can play somebody else's here. forget how this goes here. I know a guy's got a lot to lose. He's a pretty nice fella. He's kind of confused. He's got muscles in his head. Ain't never been used. Thinks he owns half of this town. Starts drinking heavy, gets a big red nose. Beats his old lady with a rubber hose. Then he takes her out to dinner. Buys her new clothes. That's the way the world goes around. That's the way the world goes around. You're up one day, next you're down. It's a half an inch of water, think you're gonna drown. That's the way that the world goes around. I'm sitting in a bathtub, counting my toes. When the radiator broke, water all froze. Got stuck in the ice without my clothes, naked as the eyes of a clown. I was crying ice cubes, hoping I'd croak. When the sun came through the window and the ice all broke, I stood up and laughed, thought it was a joke. That's the way that the world goes around. That's the way the world goes around. You're up one day, next you're down. It's a half an inch of water, you think you're gonna drown. That's the way that the world goes around. That's the way the world goes around. You're up one day, next you're down. It's a half an inch of water, you think you're gonna drown. That's the way that the world goes around. That's the way the world goes around. You're up one day, next you're down. It's a half an inch of water, think you're gonna drown. That's the way that the world goes around.
Yeah, I like that tune.
Another good one, yep.
Who wrote that one?
That's John Prine.
Wow. That was great.
Yep.
Great song.
Yep. Absolutely.
Thanks. Okay. Scott, are you ready to go next?
Yep, give me 1 second.
Hey Scott, while we're waiting. That one song you did, Olive Branch, do you mind if I memorize that and sing it and perform it here on Zoom Bar, of course, with all credit to you?
Go for it. If you want to try it, go for it.
I would love to. Thank you.
Okay, so I...
Before you get started, I see moving boxes behind you.
Oh, we're not moving. Those are just where we're like cleaning things. And we needed a staging area we are moving things around within the house, but we're not moving anywhere. Ah. But that is an astute observation.
Yeah, well, I still have plenty of those boxes just like that. So,
okay.
Oh, you've got a new sponsor.
Yeah, me too, but it's from the other store.
This is brought to you by Orange and the Power of Doing. Okay. So I have three songs instead of two because I asked to break the rules and Marie-Louise kindly said yes. Two of them are seasonal. The first one I'm going to do is not seasonal and a bit different from things I usually do. It's musical theater, and I am ambitiously doing it in the original key. And I hope all of you know this song. Hold on one second. Stuff is bothering me.
Gotta be comfortable. Gotta be comfortable.
Okay. Now I've de-jacketed. Y'all hear the piano? All right, cool. There was a time when man was kind, when their voices were soft, and their words inviting. There was a time when love was blind, and the world was a song, and the song was exciting. There was a time when it all went wrong. Something is off with the sound on my piano. I'm sorry. Let me fix this real quick. All right, we're gonna start that again from the right there.
I dreamed a dream in times gone by, when hope was high and life worth living. I dreamed that love would never die. I dreamed that God would be forgiving. Then I was young and unafraid, and dreams were made and used and wasted. There was no ransom to be paid, no song unsung, no wine untasted. But the tigers come at night with their voices soft as thunder. As they tear your hope apart, as they turn your dream to shame. He spent a summer by my side. He filled my days with endless wonder. He took my childhood in his stride. But he was gone and not today. still I dream, he'll come to me. And we will live the years together. But there are dreams that cannot be. And there are storms we cannot weather. I had a dream this life would be so different from this hell I'm living, so different now from what it seems. Now life has killed the dream I dream.
That affected me more than the bottom of the
book. That's amazing.
That's a tough one. Yeah.
Wow, I don't know how you did that.
But now that I've played one song that makes me song, I'm going to...
Need a hug?
Yeah, I'll say hug. Now that I've played one song that makes me cry a little, I'll play another song that makes me cry a little.
Happy holidays,
guys.
Hello. Hi. Hi, Scott.
Thank you for Scott.
Hi. Cheer up. Here. Let's make you smile.
You know, crying is good for musicians. Let us hear those emotions.
Okay. Cool. Next song is a holiday song, but it's an obscure holiday song, so I'm cool that way. This is a song called Snow by an artist who I think is just one dude, but he goes by Sleeping at Last. Here is Snow. Oh, that is not the right piano, unless we're doing... funky 80s holidays. There we go.
The branches have traded their leaves for white sneers. On one-headed creatures make ghosts as they breathe. Scarves are wrapped tightly like gifts under trees. Christmas lights tangle in knots annually. Our families huddle closely, letting warm against the cold. But our bruises seem to surface like mud beneath the snow. So we sing carols softly, as sweet as we know. A prayer that our burdens will lift as we go. Like young love still waiting under mistletoe. We'll welcome December with tireless hope. So let the bells keep on ringing, making angels in the snow. And may the melody disarm us when the cracks begin to show. Like the petals in our pockets, may we remember who we are, unconditionally cared for by those who share our broken hearts. The table is set and all glasses are full. Though pieces go missing, we still remain whole. We'll build new traditions in place of silence our souls. So let the bells keep on ringing, making angels in the snow. And may the melody disarm us when the cracks begin to show. Like the pebbles in our pockets, may we remember who we are. Unconditionally care for are those who share our broken hearts. This chance moves feathers, the snow piles high. Our world gets rewritten, and we twist every time. Like fresh plates and clean slates, our future is white. New Year's resolutions are reset tonight.
That's beautiful. Thank you. Want to do your third song towards the end?
I can do it now. I'm ready to do it now if that's your concern. But if you want to move to other people, I can hold it. Other song is happier.
Yeah, I'm thinking of doing the happy song towards the end.
I'll do the happy song later, now that I've done two super sad songs. Thanks, y'all.
Great. Thanks, Scott. Okay. Anybody dying to go next?
I'll go so I can get my nerves over with.
Okay, Emily. Excellent. Great.
Okay. I'm just going to read one poem. I only prepped one, so one it is. Okay, the name of this poem is called I Am the River. I'm getting my moral support from my partner on the side over here. Okay, here we go. I am the river, flow in and float out, the shallow of waves and the current of doubt. In her, I see me going awry, confused where it's leading and what will arise. Why this sharp edge here, this rock and this streak? How do the rapids control what they see? I'm learning to trust them, so with grasp I still hold. Maybe the river has more story foretold. All of the poems say she doubts not at all, but maybe her wording is not what we recall. Maybe she fears too when things start to quake. Maybe she wishes the path would stay straight. Maybe her worries aren't so much unknown, but maybe that we call this to keep her grasp to our own. I feel her imagined as she runs through my core, a lovely young quiver, cursed down by the storm. Maybe the river is not what she seems, but for now I will let her take down my sweet dreams. I wish now to see her without any grasp. I am doubting the answers, so please show me the path.
That was beautiful.
Well done.
That was beautiful.
Thank you. Thanks, everyone.
As a Toastmaster, I can't help but say the eyes are the windows to the soul. So if you can memorize that more so that you can look in the camera and people can see your soul as you read it or say it, so powerful that will be. And so congratulations on your debut. Oh,
Thank you. I need to smoke with this. I can't believe I just did that.
Yay.
Yay, you did it.
Good job.
Excellent.
And
excellent. Joseph, do you want to go next?
Okay. And this one I will have to read. I didn't memorize, contrary to what I just said. Today is a sad day for those in my hometown of Newtown, Connecticut. And this first piece I'm going to do is for one of the students who was killed on that horrific morning. It's called A Poem for Josephine Grace Gay. December 11, 2005 to December 14, 2012. Though I've seen the image many times, and I guess before I continue, I'm not sure how this comes up on the camera, but there's a heart here that circulated. It's got the names of all the victims who died at Sandy Hook School that morning. And that's what I reference in this poem. My name being Joseph, which is part of Josephine, it struck me one morning to just see it so clearly. Though I've seen the image many times, this morning it struck a nerve. I saw my name in the atrium at the top of the upper right curve. Then I read at the time of her passing, she was called the same name as me. So I wept some tears while considering the full life she never got to see. When I attended Sandy Hook School, I was living in Shady Rest. And though 40 years have passed, those memories still make me blessed. This is a poem for Joey. 9 years now to the day. After your ability to observe for yourself was unimaginably taken away. My Connecticut State Police cousin needs not imagine, only try to forget the horror that occurred in your classroom that still makes our faces wet. Josephine Grace Gay, you turned 7 3 days before. Here are some treasures you could have acquired if your journey continued some more. The loving embrace of family and friends never grows old to the soul, and so much beauty of creation unfolds each day we get to behold. The excitement of catching a crayfish, a lizard, or a snake, or the feel of drifting peacefully, kissed by breezes on a lake, or absorbing the rays of sunshine as trees chorus in the wind, or the sound of your favorite music enhancing the mood you're in, or your favorite color, purple, in flowers in the evening sky, and all the beautiful garments you never got to try. The earth is so spectacular, the wonders never end, from the colors of a glorious sunset to the feel of hanging out with a friend. The list of experiences is infinite that can season the soul with delight, and there is always a reason to dance when we're touched by the colors of light. May memories of you blossom fruit trees and gardens of magnificent blend, so you can do as angels do, blessing the world without end. Sincerely, your Sandy Hook Elementary alumnus, Joseph Joey Bradley Stegner. And I wrote that on January 15th, 2017.
That was very, very poignant.
Mm. Yeah. Thank you. Mm.
Are you going to tell me you're from Winston?
Thank you for that memory. Thank you for the remembrance.
You're welcome. So I'm going to try to make one up as I go. I like doing that for a few guys. And this one I'll do for those who had to hear those horrible bullets. For all the children who walked the halls that I got to enjoy myself. Life is so fantastic and you've seen the living edge of how it all can go to hell. And people don't understand. So whatever you do in your days, may you find the peaceful ways and take the things you've learned and let it light the fire that burns. May you shine like no one shined before. May your light be ever bright. May you take your tears and give for us what we need to get through the night. And there are voices that bring decay and they want to tear us down. May you summon from within you what can keep us above the ground. When the fools who love their weapons itch to use them for their gain, may you have the way within you to heal us of that stain. And I've seen myself what it looks like when people bleed out loud. And I know what it feels like to cry out loud from the feeling of such pain. May you take those wounds and heal the world that bleeds. May you take those footsteps that once garnered down the hall, the driveway there, there were these giant green footsteps that used to, that were painted, like the Jolly Green Giant painted down the driveway to Sandy Hook School. May you all rise like giants, giants of your time, and give the world what it needs, so upwards we can climb. There are those who want us broken, there are those who want us down, so they can ride us like we're cattle. Don't let them be so, I don't know. I'm just making this up as I go. I don't know, I just wish you all the best. And I'm a poet trying to do my thing, and I've been trying to prevent war for years. And unfortunately, we're just, poets are like flowers on a hillside, as beautiful as we may be, few ever get to see, and even fewer still take the time to really marvel at its poetry. So for whatever it's worth, my time's up. There you go.
Thank you, Joseph.
Thank you, Joseph, that was beautiful. Yay, Joseph. Yay, that was awesome. Yeah, I love that, actually. I really did. So, yeah, we all have to shine as bright as we can.
Yeah, thank you. And you do. And thank you. Your smile makes this whole show like bubble with a bouquet of flowers between each session or each performer. So thank you.
Oh, thank you. Thank you, Joseph. Okay. Jeremy, do you want to go next?
Okay, can you hear me?
Yep. Me.
Okay, I'll mute myself. Okay, there's a guitar player. He's not around anymore. Legendary guitar player named John Fahey, who grew up in Tacoma Park, Maryland, so he's local from around here. He also spent quite a bit of time out in Berkeley, California. He was one of the first guitarists to try and seriously make a living playing just instrumental acoustic finger-picking music on a guitar, and he was also kind of part of the folk, the blues revival. He was one of those people that went down to the South and rediscovered some old blues musicians, and so he was his style of music was referred to as American primitive guitar. So. And he was really basically unschooled, but if you've ever heard any of his music, you might have heard a Christmas album that he put out called The New Possibility. That was his biggest selling album. So I'm going to do some Christmas music in the style of John Fahey. I'm not sure, this is not an arrangement by John Fahey, but kind of like the kind of stuff he would do. Thank you. Cut that one short.
I love that song so much.
Jeremy's good, yeah. So crisp and clear.
Gorgeous. Wow, so beautiful. Thank you.
Yeah, well done. And that was definitely in the style of John Fahey.
I'm going to switch gears now completely.
So oh, now would you look at that?
Now for something completely different.
Completely different.
I just saw, you know, I've been watching a lot of, as everyone has, cable TV and YouTube, and there, I saw a great thing about Monty Python, about their last get together where they all got together and for the, you know, it was wonderful. Anyway, so yeah, Joe, this is a song by, it was recorded by Brooke Benton, and it was, I think it was a number one R&B hit back in mid-50s, and I think he was one of the authors on it. It was like, you know, written by one or two people, and so when what you will hear, before I did this for the other open mic, and I tried to play guitar and switch to saxophone and sing all at the same time, but that was just too stressful. So what you will hear is a backup track that I made with an application called iReal Pro, which is, if you guys don't have it, any musician should have it, because it's great as a practice tool, and it's great for making simple and easy backup tracks, quick and dirty backup tracks. And you can type in the chords, you know, you put in the chords that you want in the correct timing, and then you pick a style. So how good it turns out kind of turns out, it's whether a style really fits the kind of music, and it doesn't have all styles, so it's not as flexible as like something like Band in a Box, but it's really cheap. It's like you can get an iPad or an iPhone version for like $15 or something like that. So anyway, it's my little advertisement for iReal Pro. So here you'll hear a click at the beginning, and then we'll do the song. So I'm going to sing. Brooke Benton was had a really he had this incredibly low melodious voice, and I'll be singing Brooke Benton and through the help of proximity effect on the microphone, I will be singing lower notes than I can normally sing. So here we go. Someday, some way, you'll realize that you've been blind. Yes, darling, you're gonna need me again. It's just a matter of time. Go on, go on, till you reach the end of the line. I know you're gonna pass this way again. It's just a matter of time. After I gave you everything that I had, you left and you called me a clown. But remember, in your search for fortune and fame, what goes up must come down. I know that someday you'll wake up and you'll find that my love
Is it true love? It's just a matter of time. Fortune and fame, what goes up simply must come down. I know that someday you'll wake up and you'll find that my love is a true love. It's just a matter of time.
Anyway, that's it.
Oh, man.
Great.
Wow. He got the voice down. I remember when that was on the charts.
That was great. To have the win to do both. Good job. That did not disappoint. That was fun.
Wow, that was amazing.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to sharing that. Really well.
Wow. What a special treat. Thank you so much.
Yeah. Marie-Louise, if you know, when you're taking voice lessons, I don't know if they cover this early on, but if you look at somebody like Sarah Vaughan, a jazz singer, you'll see that, you know, they have a handheld mic, and when they want, when they sing aloud a high note, they move the mic away because your voice is naturally projects more up, and then when they try have to sing a low note, you know, it'll, the mic will be up here, and that's a cardioid mic does this, you know, so that's why they, you know, you can do that. You can play games with mics to make your voice sound better than it actually is, or smoother anyway.
Thanks for the tip. Oh,
they don't teach that in voice lessons.
I was about to say, they don't teach that in vocal training, no.
I like it, though. I think
vocal, yeah, well, traditional vocal training is singing without a mic and trying to project and
right.
I didn't even think about that, but right. You know, modern singing is all on microphones. So
yeah, true that.
Yeah. Thanks, Jeremy. I will remember that. Okay, Megan, are you ready?
Yeah, I'm ready. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, all righty. All right. I'm coming from my hotel room in Atlanta. I know I haven't like done a whole bunch of, I'm doing some covers, but I'm here to just learn more about songwriting. So that's why I'm here. And I have this acoustic here today. So I'm going to just do two songs that I just know pretty well. The first one is called A Beautiful Surprise by Indy Irie. Thank you.
just like yesterday. I didn't even know your name. And now today, you're always on my mind. Never could have predicted that I'd feel this way. You are a beautiful surprise. Intoxicate, every time I hear your voice. You got me on a natural high. It's almost like I didn't even have a choice. You are a beautiful surprise. Whatever it is that you came to teach me, I am here to learn it, cause I believe that we are written in the stars. I don't know what the future holds, but I'm living in the moment, and I'm thankful for the man that you are. You are everything I asked for in my prayers. So I know my angels brought you to my life. Your energy is healing to my soul. You are a beautiful surprise. You are inspiration to my life. You are the reason why I smile. You are a beautiful surprise.
I missed you, Megan.
All right. Nice song.
Love that song too.
You know, I missed your intro. Where are you?
In Atlanta, right outside Atlanta. I'm in Stone Mountain.
Megan, I don't know if you can see the gallery view, but I like to put it on gallery view just so I can see everyone's reactions. Emily was vibing. She got every word.
That's
one of my favorite songs of all time. Of all time. So I was really happy.
I love it too, because I was able to do it my mom in the wedding. That's why I love it too. Yeah, it's just special to me in that way. It's just the word, everything just matched the moment. It was just really cool. Yeah. I'm glad that you know it. Okay. I have another, Lovey Dovey song I do too. It's a little more upbeat. It's a kind of a style that Lauryn Hill does. So I'll do that. Okay, I was called Can't Take My Eyes Off of You. Just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you. You'd be like heaven to touch. I wanna hold you so much. At long last, love has arrived, and I thank God I'm alive. You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you. Heart in the way that I stand, there's nothing else to compare. The sight of you makes me weak. There are no words left to speak. But if you feel like I feel, please let me know that it's real. But it's too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you. I need you, baby. And if it's quite all right, I need you, baby. So on a lonely night, I love you, baby. Trust in me when I say okay. Oh, pretty baby, it, baby. Now that I found you, stay, so let me love you. Let me love you. You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you. You'd be like heaven to touch. I wanna hold you so much. As long as love has arrived, and I thank God I'm alive. You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you. Pardon the way that I stay. There's nothing else to compare. The sight of you leaves me weak. There are no words there to speak. But if you feel like I feel, please let me know that it's real. You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you. I need you, baby. And if it's quite all right, I need you, baby. So on a lonely night, so I love you, baby. Trust in me when I say okay. Oh, pretty baby, don't let me down, I pray. Oh, pretty baby, now that I found you, stay and let me love you. Let me love you.
Yay! More jamming, more singing.
All right, thank you.
Excellent.
Wow, thank you, Megan. That was beautiful.
Yeah, yay. Welcome back.
I think that was another one of Emily's favorite songs.
I know, you like went inside of my playlist of the faves.
Okay. Cool. Okay, Tom Mann. Want to go next?
Sure. I agree with Joseph, who said that stories should be memorized and spoken rather than read. But I wrote this a long time ago, and I didn't have time to memorize it for tonight. I think I may have mentioned that this gap here is. I'm waiting to get Google delivery of my Google tooth. And a Google tooth is what you put in. You take out one natural tooth and put in a Google tooth, and you have instant access to infinite information.
Oh, cool.
I'm waiting for that. And then I'll take my orals for my PhD, because I'll have everything I need to know in my mouth. And if that fails, I'll kiss the Blarney Stone first. Be that as it may. This is something that I've always been fascinated by, the transition that happened between the Santa Clara Valley and Silicon Valley. And it used to be one of the world's most productive agricultural regions in the world. And now most of the groundwater is carcinogenic. But this is about the old Santa Clara Valley. Long before the valley at the southern end of San Francisco Bay was plowed over and made into a high-tech center known as Silicon Valley. It was one of the most fertile agricultural regions in the world. Oranges, lemons, grapefruit, pears, peaches, plums, cherries, and red and white grapes grew there in abundance. But even the place names reflected an appreciation of nature, like Mountain View and Sunny Vale, and memories of saints like Francis and Claire and Joseph also grace the place names, the most meek and mild of all the saints. But every year, great storms would wash out over the regions coming out from the North Pacific and drop their winter rains. Mm-hmm. And the following summer, that rain would yield orange juice and lemonade, peach nectar, cherry jam, prune juice, Chardonnay, and Cabernet grapes. Yep. This is indeed a marvelous world that a cop.
Where'd you go?
Oops. Tom froze.
Yeah.
Tom, your video audio disappeared.
We stopped hearing you after you said, "This is a beautiful world," and I was hanging on what you were going to say next.
Well, that was my, can you hear me?
This is a beautiful world is where you left off.
Oh, you're back.
You're back.
And my front. Huh?
Yes.
This is indeed a marvelous world that a common rain can produce such an abundance and variety of beverages in a single growing season. In the same way, the one source, however it's named, is reflected in Christianity, Wicca, Islam, Buddhism, Judaism, Shintoism, atheism, and in beliefs yet to be. Defining what that one source is has led to a lot of divisions, and learned people have debated fiercely and even gone to war over the equivalent of debating whether orange juice or lemonade is the one true best beverage ever, overlooking the common rain made them all possible. Nature is showing us a much more fascinating source than we ever appreciated before. The deeper we go with electron microscopes and the higher we fly on Hubble, the cascade of interwoven existence becomes ever more spellbinding. And by the way, you can't tell when I'm reciting it, but I don't capitalize the word source, because some people will say that they speak alone for the capital S source. And that's when people start usually getting the furthest from it. It's fitting to pay attention to the source, not pretending to understand it, but simply being aware in awe of its existence and whatever unnamed or unnameable reality underpins and overarches it. Thank you.
Well said, Tom.
Yes, well said. Well said.
And by the way, it's lemonade.
that's my turf you're talking of.
So I do have to ask if it's fair to compare orange juice and lemonade, simply because orange juice is just juice while lemonade is a prepared beverage that happens to include lemon juice.
Let's not get picky here.
I'm being super picky.
Vatican. You can get a shot at the Vatican.
Bill, I will tell you, I am with you in the Church of Lemonade.
Oh, yeah.
Depends on how thirsty you are and what's available. And I tell you, a lemon straight up, breaking it in half and say is delicious when you're thirsty.
You know, Dave's granddaughters and my nieces, my grandnieces, they love sucking on lemons and limes.
Mm-hmm. They're good.
You know, it rips the enamel off your teeth, lemon.
Straight. Yeah, but it keeps you from getting scurvy.
I've always wanted to try. Has anyone heard of those miracle berry things? No one's heard of these? They're little concentrated tablets made of, I forget the actual scientific name of the fruit, but it's called the miracle berry, but it basically super amplifies for about an hour after you chew it, your sweet taste buds, and tamps down everything else. So you can eat a lemon and it'll taste like an orange.
Oh,
or drink vinegar and it'll taste sweet, which of course can be very dangerous to drink massive amounts of vinegar. But it sounds like an interesting idea in theory.
Okay. So, Bill, you want to go next?
Sure. Thank you.
You're welcome.
So, hi, everybody. So, the first song I'd like to do, Bobby Blue Bland did it first, but I don't know the two gentlemen's name that actually wrote it. And Freddie King covered it, but we don't have to deal with the third person that we know that covered it, and everybody in their mother also has covered it. But so further on up the road. Further on up the road, somebody's gonna hurt you like you hurt me. Further on up that road, somebody's gonna hurt you like you're hurting me. Further on up that road, just you wait and see. You got to reap just what you sow. That old saying is true. You got to reap just what you sow, mama. That old saying is true.
Cause just like you mistreat someone, someone's gonna mistreat you. So further on up the road, somebody's gonna hurt you like you hurt me. Further on up that road, somebody's gonna hurt you like you hurt me. Further on up that road, just you wait and see. You be laughing, pretty baby, but someday you'll be crying. You'll be laughing, pretty baby, yeah, 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 but someday you'll be crying. Someday up that road, yeah, you find out I wasn't lying, yeah. So further on up the road, somebody's gonna hurt you like you hurt me. Further on up that road, somebody's gonna hurt you like you hurt me. Further on up that road, just you wait and see. Further on up that road, you'll be all alone and blue. Further on up that road, honey, you'll be so sad and blue. Yeah, then you're gonna want me back, but I'll have somebody new. Well, you're gonna want me back, mama, but I'll have somebody new. Well, when you want me back, honey, I'll have somebody new.
And Bobby Blue Bland did do the original. He didn't write it, but he did the original recording.
Yeah, he did it first. Song. Yeah, yeah.
And everybody under the sun has covered it.
Yep. And so I'm under the sun. Well, actually, it's kind of dark out now, but yeah, I covered it too. I know. Now it's Christmas time, and we're here doing songs. So I'd like to do the Christmas song. You know, last year when I did this, I made it way too complex, and I was fiddling around with it the past week or so. And it's a lot easier to do when I keep it simple. So I hope that I don't mess it up like I did last year by keeping it simple, but we'll see. Chestnuts roasting on an open fire, Jack Frost nipping at your nose, Yuletide carols being sung by a choir, and folks dressed up like Eskimos. Everybody knows a turkey and some mistletoe helps to keep the season bright. Tiny tots with their eyes all aglow will find it hard to sleep tonight. They know that Santa's on his way. He's loaded lots of toys and goodies on his sleigh. And every mother's child is gonna spy to see if reindeer really know how to fly. And so I'm offering this simple phrase to kids from 1 to 92. Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas, Merry Christmas, Merry Christmas to you.
Merry Christmas to you.
There you go.
Bill, you did pretty good with simplifying it. The actual changes to that song, it really is a difficult song. And I think it changes key three times.
Yeah, that's right.
It's really tough.
So I kind of found a way to basically keep it in A, except for one little place. And I let my voice do the work.
Okay.
And I let it I let my voice harmonize with the chords, even though my voice was changing keys, but I left the chords basically in the key of A, D, and E.
Okay. Well, it worked.
Yeah. Thank you.
Yay. Thanks, Bill.
Thank you.
Okay, Scott, you are our closer and with our happy Christmas song.
Oh, this has never happened to me before. That was the song I was going to play. I'm not going to play the same song Bill just played.
Yes, you can play it again. It's okay. We love that song.
Sure, why not?
Bill, you're sure you won't be offended?
Not me.
We will not be offended.
Okay. Well, my version is overcomplicated. Yeah, Bill has like the nice version, and I have like, I don't even know what this is. We'll find out what it is.
Well, you go.
Okay. But yeah, Bill, you were great. So, and now for something completely different, but also the same in a different way. I don't know. Okay. Let me make sure my piano is not doing funky things this time so I don't have to pause in the middle. I also, alternatively, I do have a Christmas original that I pull out like twice a year that I could do instead. So whichever y'all prefer.
Do the one you planned.
All right, we're doing chestnuts.
Yep, go for it.
Chestnuts roasting on an open fire. Jack Frost nipping at your nose. Yuletide carols being sung by a choir of folks dressed up like Eskimos. Everybody knows some turkey and some mistletoe help to make the season bright. Tiny tots with their eyes on the globe will find it hard to see. They know that Santa's on his way. He's bringing lots of toys and goodies on his sleigh. And every mother's child is gonna smile and see if reindeer really know how to fly. And so I'm offering these simple phrases to kids from 1 to 92. Although it's been said many
times, many ways. Merry Christmas to you.
Beautifully done, Scott. Beautifully done.
Don't let me play that.
Thanks, Scott. That was gorgeous. I love that song.
I like what my dad said. My dad said, not bad for a Jew.
There you go. There you go. Yeah, I'm not sure who wrote it, but I think a Jew wrote it.
Well, I know Irving Berlin, I know, wrote White Christmas in July.
Mel Torme,
the Christmas song? Oh, well, he wasn't Jewish.
Yeah, Irving Berlin was White Christmas, though, right?
Right.
Irving Berlin also wrote the Easter's Parade song. The two most popular Christian holiday songs were written by Irving Berlin.
Thank you, Doug.
All right, well, thank you guys, and I hope everyone has wonderful holidays, whatever they celebrate. Yeah.
Merry Christmas, everybody.
Merry Christmas, everyone. Happy holidays.
Thank you.
Safe and healthy.
We love you all.
Marie-Louise, for having the
open. Yeah, much love and holiday happiness to you all.
By the way, Marie-Louise, are we on next Tuesday?
Yeah, we're on. As long as you got anybody wants to come, I'll be here.
Sure, right. Cool, okay.
Till then, have a great week.
Love you all.
That's our show. Thanks, everybody.
Bye, everybody.
Thanks, Dave. Thanks, Bill. Thanks, Joseph.
Bye, guys.
Thanks, Steve. Thanks, Jeremy. Thanks, Megan.
See you next week.
Thanks,
see you next week. Bye.
Bye. We can say Merry Christmas again.
Yes, today. Okay. Thanks, Marsha. Thanks, Wendell. Thank
you. Yeah. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye.